Good evening. This is Two Wolves. It is the 15th of October, close to midnight, and I'm reporting from southern Idaho. And as you see, I'm in RSOEEDIS. I'm actually on their alert map page under Supervolcano's Activity Report. Now, first, I want to qualify this by saying I am not a geologist. In fact, out of all of you, I'm the least versed in geological issues and most scientific issues. That is not my strong suit. So I'm going to leave the details to all of those who do this so well. But I wanted to just pitch in a little bit from the Idaho seismic perspective, as it were. As today, in the community I'm in, many people are getting really worried about the latest swarm. It's one of many. This one, though, has got people concerned because in the event of, say, a pyroclastic cloud, for instance, we would be in deep trouble here. And I'll show you some information to that effect. I wanted to give you some more perspective on this from the Idaho perspective, and also for those of you who live in bordering states, not only Wyoming and Montana, but also Utah, because this caldera is centered just about equidistantly between Idaho and Wyoming. Now, it's the Island Park Caldera that RSOEEDIS is attributing most or many of the current swarm to. Island Park Caldera, state of Idaho. Not to say there aren't others occurring elsewhere in Yellowstone. And mind you, Yellowstone Park is mostly in Wyoming, but there are parts of it are, of course, in southern Montana and the very eastern edge of Idaho as well. More commonly, what is referred to Yellowstone Park in Idaho is actually the Yellowstone-Tetonia area, not quite the park itself. Anyway, this caldera is within Wyoming and Idaho. I'll show it to you in a moment. The volcanic feature commonly called the Island Park Caldera in the state of Idaho is actually two calderas, one nested inside the other. The Island Park Caldera is the older and much larger caldera, with approximate dimensions of 58 miles by 40 miles, and its ashfall is the source of the Huckleberry Ridge tuft that is found from Southern California to the Mississippi River near St. Louis. This super eruption, 2,500 cubic kilometers, occurred 2.1 million years BP and produced 2,500 times as much ash as the 1980 Mount St. Helens eruption. The caldera clearly visible today in Idaho is the later Henry's Fork Caldera, and that's what locals call it. They call it the Henry's Fork Caldera. That is the source of the Mesa Falls Tuff. It was formed as in an eruption of more than 280 cubic kilometers, 1.3 million years BP. The two nested calderas share the same rim on their western sides, but the older Island Park Caldera is much larger and more oval and extends well into Yellowstone Park. The Island Park Caldera is sometimes referred to as the first phase Yellowstone Caldera or the Huckleberry Ridge Caldera. To the southwest of the caldera lies the Snake River Plain, which was formed by a succession of older calderas marking the path of the Yellowstone hotspot. The plain is a depression sinking under the weight of the volcanic rocks that formed it, through which the Snake River winds. Other observable volcanic features in the plain include Menin Buttes, Big Southern Butte, Craters of the Moon, Wapi Lava Field, and Hell's Half Acre. These calderas are in an area called Island Park that's known for beautiful forests, large springs, clear streams, waterfalls, lakes, ponds, marshes, wildlife, and fishing. Okay, well, as I say, I'm no expert on this. I only bring it to your attention because I wanted to clarify so that we know what we're talking about. And also, I have some other Idaho-based peripheral sources of information that might be of interest to some of you as you research this in greater depth. So here's the Island Park Caldera. It's the Wyoming line there. This is Idaho here. Idaho 15. And excuse me, I apologize to Jim Lee. Jim, I think you're amazing. And I have subscribed to Climate Viewer, and I would be there, although not being a techie, I haven't quite figured it out yet. So for tonight, because I was already in RSOEEIDS, excuse me, I'm right now in Google Earth instead. But we should all be going to Climate Viewer. So there you are. This is just for clarification. Now, let's go over here. And here's a website you might want to bookmark, www.islandparkidaho.com. This is in the Yellowstone National Park area, and it's a recreational website. So I won't read it. But this will give you some perspective on the region and the beauty and recreation it offers. And here's, they actually have a video there. So this is the town site of Island Park, which is very near to the caldera. Okay. Here's something really important. You can come here for news, among other things. Okay, so that's just something to bookmark. Island Park, Idaho. I found this. Bookmark this. Idaho Geological Survey. www.idahogeology.org. Geology and geologic hazards of the Island Park area. This being Island Park, Idaho. At the caldera. This was a 2007 Idaho Earth Science Educator Field Workshop on geology and geologic hazards of the Island Park area. It actually comes across as rather cold-blooded if you read down through this. It's interesting to note that this workshop was funded for Idaho Earth Science Educators, and some of the funders include Idaho Bureau of Homeland Security, FEMA, Idaho Geological Survey, and the Idaho Mining Association, and National Energy Foundation. This is really quite fascinating. Come here and read about this. What a funny little hidden thing to even find. Whoops. I hope I'm not going to lose it. Whoops. Okay. Well, there are some pictures of the region. This is Earthquake Lake. Earthquake Lake created by the 1959 Hebgen Lake earthquake. That's Hebgen Lake. Snowtail Mountain near Island Park. Look at, you can see the volcanic nature of the region. It's a workshop that was focused on natural hazards. Some of the things that they studied were the fact that not only does Yellowstone have earthquakes, lava flows, ash flow tufts, hydrothermal explosions, and those famous geysers, but also dangerous concentrations of CO2 that may have killed a herd of bison. It's really an interesting page. So bookmark this, and I'll put it down below. They also studied Earthquake Lake, where an enormous earthquake-induced landslide dammed the Madison River, killing 23 people. This is very cold-blooded. It'll give you some perspective to read this. Oh, well, it just killed 23 people, okay? We viewed the National Forest Service video on the quake. We moved on to Hebgen Lake Dam and nearby damaged road and building sites. These stops demonstrated how vulnerable dams and reservoirs can be to severe earthquakes. Anyway, it looked like they were having fun discussing natural hazards. We won't hang out there. I want to go on to something else while I have time. Now, this is the Bureau of Homeland Security, Idaho page, bhs.idaho.gov. Putting down roots in earthquake country. Ooh. That's just sad. Putting down roots in earthquake country. And then I'm having trouble enlarging, but to the right it says your handbook for earthquakes in Idaho. And this is also put out by Idaho Citizen Corps. There we go. And the Idaho Geologic Survey, Homeland Security, Idaho Citizen Corps. Now, bookmark this page, you guys, because there's a lot here This is printed by the Idaho Bureau of Homeland Security, 2009. Here's a URL. And I wanted you to take a look at this, even though I'm having trouble keeping my window where it should be, so you'll just have to bear with me. Because this applies not only to Idaho, but to neighboring states. And I'll show you a few pages while I have time that will point out why this is potentially way more serious than it's looking at the moment. It's a 40-page book. There is a lot of, to their credit, there's Butch Otter, the governor, there's a lot of information here. And I will credit them for that. Idaho is earthquake country. Anybody want to donate a new computer? No, just kidding. Okay. So Idaho is earthquake country. Now, I want you to read through this. Idaho is your home. Maybe not for long. There's some really good information on seismicity here. As you scroll through, you'll find this page. Coast Range, Basin and Range Provinces, Snake River Plain, Rocky Mountains, talking about fault scarps, upwelling heat, as we know, normal faults, mantle. And this is really important. This page here, the Yellowstone Tectonic Parabola. This is Yellowstone. Island Park's over here. This is Idaho Falls. This is Sun Valley. This is Pocatello. This is the area we're looking at right here. Okay, that's the area we're looking at. And this is really important just for people that live in this area to start getting prepared. Oops. I'm frustrated by my computer. In all parts of Idaho, our history reveals earthquake hazards. This is going to tell those who are interested. History of earthquakes strongly felt in Idaho, even when originating from neighboring states. Therefore, by extraction, we can go on to extrapolate, I should say, that any earthquake occurring in Island Park could conversely affect these areas in return. And here's your magnitude. Date, origin, and the way that it affected given areas. This page coming down here indicates some of the largest quakes that have happened in this part of Idaho. Again, here we go, Idaho Falls, Wyoming border, Snake River Plain, a seismic area. And let's see, I shouldn't make videos this late at night, maybe. Recorded seismicity of the Idaho region. Look at that. There you go. And here's something very important to note, and it's one of the reasons I made this video. Wyoming border, seismicity, Island Park, right in here. Idaho Falls, Pocatello. Okay, tools, what is the INL? The INL is the Idaho National Laboratory, the extremely mysterious, really quite sinister nuclear laboratory. Nobody really knows everything that goes on there. It sits on the Snake River, and it's in the direct line of disaster. There it is, INL. Make a note. Okay. And dams. The other thing to point out, if you live anywhere near a dam in Idaho, just look at this. I'm running out of time, but okay, there's the INL, there's Rexburg, Teton Fault, Grand Valley Fault, Palisades Dam, Idaho Falls, there's the INL, I'm not going to let you forget about the INL, Pocatello, American Falls Dam, lot down river from that. So these are just some things. Central Idaho seismic zone yet again. This is Hebgen Lake. Remember Hebgen Lake? We were just talking about Hebgen Lake earthquake led to a number of people dying. Here's Yellowstone, Idaho border. There's the caldera. Okay, this is just two wolves putting in her two cents worth, and good night.